distance, temperature, weight, we're always converting something from one unit to the other. In today's video, we're gonna make a simple unit converter that will allow you to convert all the units you want. All right, guys, here we are inside Visual Studio Code again, all right? So, first of all, I'm going to start by printing a new line and then a little title like that. All right, unit converter. I'm gonna print another line. So now I'm actually going to create a list of tuples. So conversions. Because here we're not actually going to make a simple like kilometers to miles, etc., etc., but we're going to make something that you can use for all the conversions. So you can actually add conversions to it. You know, I'm just going to make a few different conversions, but you can add as many as you want. So I'm actually going to copy the list like that. So here we've got a tuple with the conversion, right? So this is the number, okay? So this is actually the unit to convert, and this is what we want to convert to, all right? So this is the same. So this is actually how I set this up. So then I'm going to print to the user all the conversions available, which conversions are available, all right? I'm gonna print, and then I'm going to use tuple unpacking. So conversion number from unit to unit in conversions available, print. Then I'm going to use an F string. All right, perfect. Let's actually see what we've got so far. All right, so if everything is working or not. So I'm gonna save the file and open a new terminal. All right, Python, unit converter. All right, so as you can see, unit converter, conversions available, etc., etc. So everything is working, perfect. Let's do this, all right. Now, I'm actually going to, you know, ask the user for the conversion to use, all right? So conversion is equal to input, enter the number of the conversion to use, like that. And then I'm going to do something like conversion index equal int conversion minus one. So I'm actually subtracting one to the number entered by the user, because if the user, you know, entered one, for example, which is the first one, the index of this is actually zero, right? If the user entered two, the index would be one, etc., etc. So I'm actually going to do that. As usual, I'm not going to check if the user entered a letter or something like that. You should definitely do that if you want to make the program better. I'm not gonna, as always, you know, check everything, because it's going to make the video too long. All right, so I'm actually assuming that, you know, the user actually enters the right number. All right, perfect. Then I'm actually going to use tuple unpacking again. So number from unit to unit, and then conversion available, and then conversion index. All right, so I'm actually unpacking just the tuple that I need. All right, in this case, the tuple at this index. I'm going to print a little space, and then I'm going to do something like from value float input, then a string, enter from unit, like that. All right, so here we actually, you know, converting the input, which is always a string, you know, input always returns a string, we are converting it to float, right? And here we are telling the user enter, you know, kilometers, stuff like that. Perfect. And then print. So here we're actually going to add the logic for all the different conversions. All right, so if conversion number is equal to 1, then to value is equal to from value times 0.62. All right, I'm gonna print string. So from value from unit, to value, to unit. All right, so we're actually printing the result. Let's actually have a look at how this all works, and then we can add the other ones. All right, so let's save it. Do this and then this. All right, so Python unit converter. All right, enter the number of the conversion to use. I'm going to use the first because it's the only one that we actually added. So 1, enter kilometers. All right, let's say 10 kilometers. As you can see, 10 kilometers equal 6.2 miles. All right, so this is how it works, and that's working really well. Let's actually add all the others. You can do something like live conversion number equal 2, for example. Let's actually give it some more room. To value equal from value times 1.61, print. We can actually copy and paste this like that. All right, so this should work as well, and I'm going to actually copy and paste all the other conversions. All right, so like this. As you can see, we've got all the different conversions. All right, so we could actually save this and try to run it and see. All right, so let's see that we want the 6th, let's say 24.3. Yeah, and here you've got the result. I know this is a little bit too long, all right, because this is a float. And if you don't actually format it in a different way, you are going to have this result, right? But you could actually format strings in a different way. You could remove all of these zeros and stuff and just, you know, keep 2 decimals, you know, after the point. I'm not going to do that. This is not, you know, the purpose of this video. The purpose of this video is actually to build a unique converter, and we've actually done that.